In this interview, Hervé Lacon of Winston to Pay delves into the initiatives, goals, and changes in the instant payments industry.
Hello, my name is Aya Karliva, and thank you for taking the time to join this interview for Financial IT.
My name is Hervé Lacon. I am the Chief Innovation Officer of Winston Pay and a co-founder. My focus is in product development and leveraging innovation in the financial market.
How has the global pandemic changed the payments industry?
The global pandemic has changed the payment industry on many levels. I mean, it's changed the way we do business. A lot of purchases are happening online. This is fairly easy for the developed world, but in emerging countries, it becomes more of a challenge. There is a big opportunity for the delivery of a business transaction using the wallet payment alternative. There's been also some change in the integration of crypto for the settlement.
Has Winston Pay benefited by the pandemic or declined? So what has changed?
I would say a little bit of both, right? There's obviously been a retrenchment in the in some of the shift in focus. For example, we had a financial institution that were asking us to develop more fraud prevention on our front end, and those are taking a step back. So that's on the negative side. On the positive side, there is a real opportunity and a real need to facilitate real financial inclusion. So SMEs being able to come from emerging countries and participate in the global trade, the global payments. The settlements through e-commerce site has increased, I think, 40% in the last quarter, where we've integrated our payment platform with platforms such as NopCommerce and therefore facilitating that payment, whether it's online or offline.
What are the key trends and challenges shaping the industry?
Some of the key trends that remains are in compliance. That's a challenge, especially when you don't have as much compliance information. And the ability to switch from online to offline and authenticate yourself. Those are some of the, I would say, trend and challenges, which we focus on with our World KYC initiative to be able to share some of the compliance information through the payment chain when it's digitally, either through SWIFT or others.
Is cash still essential, or is digitalization really the way to go?
I would say both. One of the things that we've seen is a reduction in the use of cash because of COVID. One of the initiatives that we have with one of our partner in Ireland, Pipit, is really to digitalize cash. So basically, you can deposit at the post office through Pipit British pounds, and then they can be credited for settlement of a business transaction, like an invoice or a deposit. And cash, I would say there's three main reasons to use cash today. One, support the unbanked, the people that do not have a mobile phone or do not have the technology or the know-how to use some of the wallet. The second one is privacy, right? People that want to pay in cash, they don't want to know that I bought a hamburger thing when I'm supposed to be on diet. Whatever the reason is, the privacy. The third one is usually criminal, right? I want to do, well, criminal if it's tax evasion, non-criminal if it's tax avoidance, but really also money laundering. We are fully conscious of those, and we focus on, in our product, and number one, to service the unbanked, providing them with our technology of a card that can be used for tap and pay and QR code payment. So empowering somebody with a $15 phone to become a merchant. We also provide anonymity at the discretion of the merchant. So, you know, when I tap and pay, you just have basically kind of like having a new virtual credit card being offered on the fly, right? And three, the idea of having compliance and being able to share your compliance information online or offline. This is really kind of where we've done some initial development, and we continue to develop to be able to share the compliance where it makes sense.
The fintech market is obviously large and growing. How do you compete in a sea of other companies?
The global payment world has much more opportunity for collaboration and competition. You have a clear example of what we're trying to achieve with what was done by Zelle in the US in order to compete with Venmo. So take that model, and this is really what we're doing with Winston Pay, but for individual, for businesses, for multi-currency, including commodities, loyalty points, or crypto. And so being able to aggregate that network so that they can work with each other, and that's where we see more opportunity for partnership than competition.
Thank you for taking the time today once again and talking to us about your company, Winston Pay.
Thank you so much.